September 29th, 2014. It's 3:28 p.m. And I've tilled up most of the garden, about 85% of it. Over here, that's been tilled about four times. And this is all gonna have plastic on it. It's right now it's probably about 42 by 41 or 42 feet instead of 40 by 40 because I've gone a little bit further over. Stops here where the black-eyed peas are at. Of the eight black-eyed peas, all of them are producing pods, and slowly but surely we've been picking them off as they get dried out. There's purple hull pea right there, and there's one purple hull pea right up here, right in the front there. Well, here's a purple hull pea. These are black-eyed peas. And we got the okra right here. See, I tilled up right here. This took all this out. Got the peanuts out of here. It wasn't a lot, but, you know, like I said, live and learn for next year. But we got some, we had two peanut plants out here. So I got okra still here. Still got my four burgundy and three green pod okra. Heirloom, all of them heirloom. I've got my knife on me, but I can't do it while I'm filming, so I'm just going to wait. There's a couple of pods on the okra I want to cut off. And it's better off cutting the okra off rather than trying to pinch it off or twist it. But I can see a couple green, three or four green, and two or three red ones, burgundy ones. But I tilled all this up here. This has only been tilled like two times. And you see where these peppers are. I've already got rid of the first few peppers here because of mainly overwatering and the rain and the flood, and then overwatering them more. We more or less diseased all our tomato plants. Out of 30 some odd tomato plants, we had probably three that put out some tomatoes. And that was only sporadic. But I still have some bell peppers right there. One. They call them wonder peppers too, but, or keystone pepper, wonder pepper. There's one large one there. There's another one on there somewhere. I can't see it in the viewfinder here. But there's another pepper plant, two pepper pots. I'm going to go in closer. Let me zoom this out a little bit. As you can see, right down there, you see those two peppers. There's two. There's another one down there. And that one there, the small one. That's the bigger. There's two down there. Those are bell peppers. This one's gonna get ripped up here in a few, in another day. That's gonna get ripped up. This should be a ghost pepper, or a habanero pepper, habaneros. You can see there's a couple of peppers on here just now coming up. It's been a bad year. Here's another big bell pepper. Let me see that one. About the size of a baseball. And there's a small one on top. Another one back here in this one. I mean, it's the 29th of September. This should have all been done. But, see, all the eggplant and everything back here is all tilled up. I started to go over that way a little bit, connecting it, because this is all going to be tilled up in the back. And like I say, the garden's going to come out another 3 feet to the just to the right of these peppers right here. You see that stake down there, that stake, tomato stake, broken one. I can't see on this viewfinder for anything. Right there, you see that stake? It's about 3 inches to the right or so, west. So that's all gonna be tilled out down here, all the way to that one in the back there. I was using that old mustard jar before bottling to market. But I'm gonna stake, you can see I got stakes around the edge of it, the perimeter. Do a better job, this is just the ballpark right now. Let's see those here. I can't see it on the viewfinder. There's a big okra pod on there. Right there. I mean, usually you get about four or five on each one. And every two or three days you can get four or five again. But like I said, this has just been a trial and error thing. This should be the last time, too. If we get plastic, the garden will be approximately 42 by 42 feet. Okay, but it'll be plastic. you know, all the way across. And then I'll have one, two on my bun, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, possibly 12 rows across. And like I said, what it is it'll go from north to south to north, and we'll go out so many feet, and we're gonna put X's, approximately 12 inches. The X will be 12 inches one way, 12 inches that other way. And then when it gets time to plant the plants, because they're all going to come up in pots, we'll curve the corners in, so you'll have a big, you'll have about a 4 or 5 inch circle, like, not even a circle, just open spot there. We'll dig down, put a little bit of lime in there, put some soil on top of that, a little bit of fertilizer, and a little soil, and then put the plant down on top of that, and just pull it all around it, you know, because like I said, this is going to have to be flattened down a little bit, even out. So it'll look really, really different. This will just be like one big black square out here. And like I said, all that'll be up here in the next two weeks, maybe 3 weeks. Just tilling everything into the ground here. You see all the dried up like roots and grass right here. These were plants. So it'll be a 42 by 42 approximately. And I get an exact measurement. I keep bringing it out about a foot and a half each way as I re-till, because like there, you see how the plants come up to there. Then I come just this side of the plant, which makes the garden a little bit longer or a little bit wider. And just go all the way around like this. And like I said, it'll get a little bit wider. And it's really decent soil. Plus with the lime and the 15-15-15 fertilizer I'll be putting out here, I'm going to put a little bit down, and I'm going to till it into the ground, cover it. And I believe, now I'm not positive on this yet, I'll be removing the plastic, throwing some more 15-15-15 fertilizer on it, and replacing the plastic. And then as the plants get bigger, probably around April of next year, I'll be transplanting them out here, as it's, you know, because it all depends on the weather. But with the plastic, it gives you an extra couple months of growing, you know, about 5 weeks early, 3 to 5 weeks early and 3 to 5 weeks late, because it keeps the heat in the ground. But, you know, start growing everything around the beginning of February, second week of February, inside, in planters, tomatoes, peppers again, even black-eyed peas, grasshopper down here, black-eyed peas. Like I say, everything that's out here now is peppers, okra, black-eyed peas, purple hull peas. Okay, so all that's going to be a little bit differently too. I'm going to head over there because this gets less sun later in the day, so I might have okra in the first or second row over here in the back there, probably about 10 feet this way to the back. It'll be zucchini, pumpkin, squash as it goes across. But again, this will all be black, so it'll be like four slots for zucchini, and four squares for pumpkin, four squares for squash, and watermelon. That's the only thing, watermelon. I might actually dig that out a little bit over that way, make a little bit of a little edge, about, you know, 8 feet, 9 or 10 feet this way, and over about 5 or 6 feet. Just have four watermelons back there. That'd be more than enough. When it produces on the vine, you'll get anywhere from 3 to 5 watermelons per plant. So we don't eat that much. This year we had 2, and then we got 4 watermelons off there, but we were picking them too early again, and we didn't work this garden like it should have been worked. Better than all of them in the past, but now we know more about not watering them every single day or every other day and all this, because there's too much water and it'll give you root rot, which you can see the plants, how they suffered over the months here. You keep the plants till they get about 12 inches tall in planters. You come out here and you make your spot. Like I say, dig down, put a little bit of some lime, a little bit of lime, put, or fertilizer. Put your plant on top of a little soil, then put your plant on top of that and go about, you know, 18 inches away. So we could probably have about 15 of everything straight back, and that'd be more than enough for 2 people, easy. I mean, those are eight black-eyed pea plants right there, and they're all way too close together. Like I said, I had no idea. This has all been trial and error this year. So I was eight. I was going to do 12. Well, actually 15, but I'm going to space them out. Like, see, there's three baskets together. The first and third basket will be the first and second next year, and so forth, all the way back. So I'll have at least 12. It could be as many as 15 like that over in this area. But north to south is the best way to plant. I didn't even realize that. I had them last year, east to west. Now I'm going to do it the right way, north to south. So if you're planting a garden and you got any kind of area, even if you got like 10 feet by 10 feet, try to make your rows run north to south. And you should have a little bit better growth than east to west.